We'll solve a problem related to polynomial functions. A polynomial function h of x has been given. The equation is 3x to the fifth plus 2x to the fourth plus 15x cubed plus 10x squared minus 528x minus 352. We can see that this function is of degree 5. One of the zeros has been given, 4i. And we're asked to use the given zero to find the remaining zeros. Well, if 0 plus 4i is one root, then 0 minus 4i is another root. So we now know two of the five zeros of this function. We can write the function in factored form, and it would look like this: x minus 4i times x plus 4i, and then we would have some leftover cubic polynomial factor. So what we want to do is figure out what would be that cubic factor. Well, let's simplify x minus 4i times x plus 4i. That'll be x squared minus 16i squared, but I squared is negative 1, so we have x squared plus 16 times this cubic. All right, so what do we do with that information? We're going to take the original polynomial function, and we're going to divide by x squared plus 16. But to use polynomial long division, we don't want to forget the 0x term when we use our division. So the first thing we do is we look at x squared, and we ask ourselves the question, x squared times what is 3x to the fifth? X squared times 3x cubed. But we want to put it over the x cubed term. Now we're going to take that term, 3x cubed, and multiply it by each term in the divisor. And we're going to subtract this from the three terms up above, remembering that when we subtract, we add the opposites. So we get 2x to the fourth minus 33x cubed, and then you bring down that plus 10x squared. And we go through the process again. X squared times what is 2x to the fourth? X squared times 2x squared is 2x to the fourth. So we take our 2x squared, multiply it by the three terms in the divisor. We are going to subtract, and we remember to add the opposite. Bring down your negative 528x. Same question now. X squared times what is negative 33x to the third? That would be negative 33x. Let's multiply that negative 33x by the divisor. We subtract and we bring down. And our final step here is x squared times what is negative 22x squared? That would be negative 22. Let's multiply the negative 22 times each term in the divisor. We're going to subtract, and our remainder is 0. So what I do when I have a remainder of 0 is I now have figured out another way to write the original polynomial function. We can write it as the divisor times the quotient. So we're going to take our original h of x, and it can be rewritten as x squared plus 16 times that quotient. Now what I want to do is look at the cubic polynomial that's inside the parentheses, and I want to factor that by grouping and using the reverse box strategy. So my cubic term goes there, my negative 22, and then the remaining two terms can go in either location. Along the top of the box, I have an x squared term that is a like term to both. X squared times what is 3x cubed? 3x. x squared times what is positive 2x squared, positive 2. And then 3x times what is negative 33x. And double check that the constant terms multiply together correctly. Negative 11 times positive 2 is negative 22. So now I have factored that cubic polynomial. And the factors are along the outside of the box. So x squared minus 11 times 3x plus 2. And x squared minus 11, we can factor that using the difference of perfect squares, but just understand that we have to use the square root of 11, right? Okay, so what have we done so far? We have taken an original polynomial function h of x, we used one of the zeros, we used polynomial long division, we then factored by grouping, and we keep rewriting this in factored form. What I want to do now is look at the x squared plus 16 and break that down into the difference of perfect squares. It'll be x minus 4i times x plus 4i. And at this point, I now can figure out my zeros. I have a real zero. It's rational at negative 2/3. I have irrational zeros at the square root of 11 and negative square root of 11, and I have complex zeros at 4i and negative 4i. So the zeros, we know that there are five of them if it's a fifth degree polynomial, are here. Again, I love to type in my function into a graphing utility like Desmos to check that the answers that I got make sense. So I fiddled around with my window, and I found a window that works nicely. And then when I type in my function, I notice that, in fact, there is one rational zero at negative 2/3. There are two irrational real zeros, square root of 11 and negative the square root of 11. And the other two zeros do not intersect the x-axis because they are complex zeros.